So during my time on YouTube, I've uploaded a bunch of footage of me playing some old school arcade and console games online. So back around 2006 up until 2010, I was playing on a service called Kylera, which allowed me to play some online games. For example, games on Nintendo, Super Nintendo, arcade games, and even Nintendo 64 games. Now, I also did try a little bit of 2D Fighter, which I believe now is known as Supercade, but I think it's not maintained anymore. So I did try that service for a short time and it was pretty decent. And afterwards, I came across something called GGPO, but because of some issues I had with ports, I could never get GGPO to work properly. So up until now, I didn't really use anything to play online with these older games until I discovered something called Fightcade. So the installation process for Fightcade was actually pretty simple, and getting online to play with people was pretty simple as well. I also did not have to open any ports to play online, and that was awesome. That was perfect because that was the main drawback that did not allow me to play GGPO, because sometimes I have port issues and they just don't work when I open them. Now, if you have questions about Fightcade or any problems, then their website doesn't really have much information and the forums aren't really that active. Now, you might get a reply, but there's also a subreddit section for this service on Reddit, so you can also go over there if you have any questions, if you want to branch out and try to get help in other areas. So, right now, I have around three problems with Fightcade, and it's all based around Neo Geo fighting games. So my first problem is there are some macros that are set to ABC, BCD, and ABCD, but for some reason when I try to put a specific button for that macro, it doesn't let me put it on my controller, and that's really weird because there's an option for you to set a key for those macros right there in the emulator, but it's not letting me put it there. It's like locked away for some reason. So it doesn't make any sense. So in order to get it to work, I have to go into the INI files and manually put in a specific key in there for each macro. My next problem is that there are no macros set for AC, which is 2 punch, BD, which is 2 kick, and BC, which is weak kick and strong punch. And these are common used inputs in Neo Geo based fighting games, like for example, SVC Chaos and the King of Fighters series. Now you might think it's only pushing 2 punch and 2 kick at the same time, but when you're playing on a controller and pushing buttons with your thumb, it's a little awkward tilting your hand or the controller just to reach over and get 2 punch and 2 kick, and then getting BC at the same time is a little awkward because they're diagonally across from the buttons on a controller. So on an arcade stick, yes, it's very easy, but if you're playing on a controller, it's a little bit harder, so you're somewhat limited. And my last problem here is around the desync issues around Neo Geo fighting games. Now, this has been a known issue for such a long time, and I thought this service would not have that problem. Now, it does not happen that often. It's really rare, but I did notice it happen recently. So I went to watch one of my replays through the website, and what I saw in the replay did not reflect what I saw in the live match. Now, this has never affected games on the CPS-based boards, for example, Street Fighter, Marvel vs. Capcom, X-Men vs. Street Fighter, and games like that. It's only affected Neo Geo games for the longest time, so just keep that in mind. Now, what about activity? Which games on the service are the most popular? So, after trying this for about a week, I can tell you that the most popular games on here are King of Fighters 95, 97, 98, Marvel vs. Capcom, Street Fighter Alpha 3, Street Fighter 3 Third Strike, Super Street Fighter 2 X Grandmaster Challenge, and sometimes Samurai Showdown 2. Everything else gets around 15 players or less on random times throughout the day. Now, there's even a cool stats page on the website that shows you what countries are mostly using the service. Now, Fightcade has a pretty big library of supported games, but most of them are fighting games. However, there are a few beat 'em up games and shoot 'em up games if you got a friend to try those with. The supported games on here mainly run on the CPS1, CPS2, CPS3, and Neo Geo hardware. And this is because Fightcade uses the Final Burn emulator, and that's always been known to run those types of hardware. So if your favorite game is not on their list, then it's most likely because that game is not part of the CPS or Neo Geo family. So what about lag and input delay? How good is it online? So I live in Canada and I have a really good input response and very little lag when I play with people who are in Canada, America, Mexico, and even Japan. However, anywhere further outside those regions and I start to see some really bad lag and frame skipping. Now, I also want to point out that some people out there are going to get so uptight because they're going to say that they only want to use a service that lets him play from America all the way to Germany or Russia with no lag at all. But in reality, that's not always possible because you have something called the ocean that separates both these regions on the world. So it doesn't really matter how good your upload speeds are for both these players, it's still going to have a long time to reach from one point of the world to another. So it's a huge amount of distance that the signal has to travel. So I'm not saying this service has to be that great, I'm saying for what it does offer, it's pretty good. Now what about the interface menu? Is it easy to use and do you have to change any settings at all? Well, it turns out that it's not that hard to get used to. Now, I never had to touch any of the options in the Action or the Settings tab, so the default settings must be all I need to play online just fine. Now, there is an option called Smoothing or Input Delay, and I guess this is supposed to help with the online lag if there is any, but I just leave it at the default setting, which is at 1. Now, I also never really got to play the same person twice right away after a match to even test if changing that setting would even impact my online experience. There are also some visual filters that you can change to make your game look even better. There's even a direct hyperlink in the chat menu that links you to the replay of your last set of matches, which makes it easier for watching them over again. Now overall, it's a really good service if you want to play some old school arcade games. Now by everyone else's standards, it may not be perfect, but for what it does offer, it works really well. So after using the service for about a week, I gotta say I did have a lot of fun and I am pleased with the results the service has provided me. So it's pretty damn good, it just has a few little problems. So overall, I'm gonna give it a score of 8.5 out of 10. So that is my review on Fightcade, which is a program that allows you to play old school arcade games online. Now I also want to point out that this service has to be maintained and updated by an individual, so at some point in the future, there is a chance it could get shut down and is no longer supported. And this has happened in the past, for example with services like Kylera, 2D Fighter, Supercade, GGPO, and other emulators that are no longer updated or supported. So just keep that in mind in the future. So this is the end of my review on Fightcade. If you guys enjoyed the video or if it was helpful in some sort, then please leave a thumbs up. I will also leave the last match in this set without commentary so you guys can enjoy it just like that. So thank you guys very much for watching and stay tuned because I'll see you guys in the next video. I'll see you later.